What's up, boys? So I got in a little fender bender the other day. You can see my headlights pushed in a little bit. I rear-ended this lady. She was super cool about it. Totally my fault. I'm a dick. So basically what's going on here is my headlights pushed in. The radiator core support is bent. I gotta fix it. I'm missing a little piece of my hood here. This guy's looking at me like I'm crazy. But yeah, so I'm at Harbor Freight. I'm gonna get a come along. I'm gonna show you how to fix this shit. So this right here, exactly what you need. $30. I'm gonna buy it and then we'll see how that works. What's up? So I'm back from Harbor Freight. I got my winch puller here. I'm gonna break it open. It was like $30. I picked up some other stuff too. I got a little roller chair for the garage. Very cool. So, yeah. I gotta figure out how this works. Gotta read the manual. I gotta read, see how this shit works. Warning. Oh shit. So you can see here, I got it's bent right there, you know, and that's why the headlight's all jacked, because it's not sitting right. The headlight attaches right to the radiator support, and so first thing I'm going to want to do is take out my headlight and then hook up my comb along and start going. This side's a little bent too, but it's not bad, so I'm not worried about that side. Also, my hood doesn't latch shut because this part is folded too far back, you know, so it won't latch. And I got this bungee cord, and I'd really like to get rid of the bungee cord and put my little plastic piece back on that side so I can be a stabby and fresh again. And so let's get to it. All right, so I got two of these when I was in there in Harbor Freight, and I'm gonna hook one up to a tree that's next to my driveway and hook the other one up to my car, and then I'll show you when I do it. But yeah, so it's just a they're like $10 a piece. It's like 6 feet long. That's all you need. All right, so this is the setup here, boys. Check me out. So I wrapped the strap around the support where it's bent, like a few times to kind of even out the, you know, so it doesn't like bend in one spot. So if I just pull in one spot, it'll just bend right there. So I'm hoping that'll do the trick. Got the headlight out. I got it hooked up to this tree. So I hope the tree, I mean, obviously the tree's gonna be strong enough, right? I mean, it's not gonna pull down the fucking tree. So I'm gonna set up the camera and then I'm gonna film this. So it's either gonna be a total win or a total fail. So we'll see what happens. What do you think, buddy? Is this gonna work? No? Oh, that's a no.
Alright, here it goes. Yeah, he's sleeping. Alright. What are you doing to your car? I'm trying to bend my radiator support back because I got in an accident. Yeah.
Thank you. So one more time, the name of the dog.
Chevy.
Chevy.
Like the truck.
Oh, yeah, the truck. Car. Okay.
Take it easy, my man. All right, well, it looks like it's working, but I can't figure out how to get the... I can't figure out how to release the pressure of the come along. So that's cool. Cause I'm gonna go Google that right now, I suppose. Cause like this is how you release the thing in there. You pull back on this guy, but I had to pull on this part and then press back on this, and that released it almost like a double action gun. But yeah, so I got that. This looks better, but it's still not all the way. I think maybe if I pound it with a hammer or something, but I'm gonna see how my headlight looks on there, and then I'm gonna go from there. So, all right, so it's looking a lot better. I got it to like close the gap a bit, but I'm still not satisfied with it. So I'm gonna go for round two with the come along, and then that should put me where I want to be. So, yeah, think that this part right here. Let me take this out. I'm starting to think that this part, this whole piece, is bent. And so I think if I just, I can probably just bend that back a little bit, and then that my headlight should be flush. It really blows my mind, you know, the fucking headlight is just the most complicated part on the whole goddamn car, I swear to God. I think I'm still pretty far off here. So what the deal is you can just see the reason why it's not latching is because there's like a, it's like a square, and the latch is right on the underneath of the corner of the square. So here's the latch and here's the square hook, and it's, so it's not gonna latch over because this, so I gotta come up like a whole nother, maybe a half of an inch. So, just get back at it. I need a smoke break. What I need is a goddamn cigarette. So I'm gonna have a cigarette, and then we'll get back to this. I've decided that right here needs to come forward. So I'm gonna do a little bit of surgery. I'm gonna take off my radiator supports, a couple 12 millimeters, and then I'm gonna slip my little tow strap through here, and then I'm just gonna pull it ever so gently to try to bend that piece out to try to get it to where my hood latches again. So that's next. Okay, so I've rigged up a little something. It's an old ratchet strap, and then I fed that through there, and then I made some kind of knot and tied it to the hook on the winch, and I'm gonna try to pull that hood latch. So this is how I got it rigged up, and there's a radiator support cam. So we're gonna start tightening up our winch here.
Well, that looks like it definitely is working. I'm just gonna try to let this down.
Okay, so since I'm too stupid to use the tools that I have, what I did is I just put the car in neutral and then I pushed it forward to release slack. Let me show you the progress that we've made.
All right, you ready for this? Voila, hood closes. It's definitely still not perfect, but the hood latches. I consider that an absolute win. It's starting to look better, I think. So that's good, but I gotta keep messing with it. All right. Cool, so now, I'm gonna take this out. Put that there. Okay. Okay, well, it looks like it's just moving my car, so I'm gonna put that. That stops happening. Okay. Maybe a couple.
So right there, is looking kind of bent. So I'm gonna take a nice pair of old pliers, I'm gonna bend that shit back. Oh yeah. Bodywork. Alright, so look at it now. Looks a lot more flush. The headlight's actually sticking out of.
Here's the moment of truth. See what it looks like with the hood closed.
Not bad. I gotta bend my hood somehow to get that to sit more down. But yeah, I think this was pretty good considering. Okay, so here's a thought, right? My hood's still bent up a little bit on this side. I kind of stood the hood up and I bent it a little bit. I just cranked it to the one side and it seems like it's sitting a lot more flush. And so what I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this little wooden block that I have and I'm gonna put it underneath my hood
in the right spot and hopefully under here, and then bend the hood down. And then I think that will bend this down enough to sit flush. So let's try it. What's the worst that can happen, right? Okay, so I think a good spot to do the that didn't go as planned.
Back to the drawing board, I suppose.
So the hood actually just bent right over the thing and then closed on the 2x4. I suppose maybe that worked a little bit. But I think I gotta go higher up. Just bending at will here. I think I need a new hood. All right, I think she looks a lot better. I still need to get a hood for it, but I think that it looks pretty decent. I mean, what can I say? I don't specialize in collision repair, but what can I say, man? What do you think, Chevy? Not bad, right? You proud of your dad, Chevy? You proud of me? High five. High five, dude. Yes. Yes. Give me five, dude. Give me five, dude. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. We're hyped. I think we did a good job. So. And that's going to be it for the video. I still need to get a hood for it. This fucking hood is just shredded, dude. I don't think there's any fixing that, you know? So. Yeah, but until next time. Thank you for watching.